Hi ladybugs, and today I'm going to show you how to do a doodle board. Another very easy, quick thing to do, because we often, and what is a doodle board you may ask? You know, we do our beautiful journals, we make them and we put all sorts of gorgeous stuff inside, but then when you come to write, it's a problem. So I use my doodle boards as something firm to write on. Much easier, and that way you're not bumping and lumping over stuff. So that's what we're going to do today. And I, as you can see, I've made several already. They're pretty plain. You can use anything, you know, it's like doing a master board on some of them. On this particular one, I have used wallpaper. I just edged it with some washi tape, because the edge was showing, and I didn't, you know, because you'll see how I do it, very easy. And then I added this on the edge, and you want to make them as smooth as possible, obviously, for writing. And I just put some fabric hooks on there, so it just makes it easier to put in your journal, and it looks prettier, so it can live in the journal. Okay. So there's this one, and then I just use scrapbook paper on the back. So this one you can use on both sides. I made an industrial one, and I added just a little bit of a chain and a charm. So once again, it hangs out the journal, and it just looks amazing. I make them all different sizes. I make them with whatever I have at hand. You can see I just patched this together. And on that side, and this one, which I'm going to finish up with you. I made this the same as I would make a master board. I just tore stuff, papers up, glued them on, making sure to keep it as flat as possible, because when there's a bump, you know what it's like when you write. I don't have to tell you that. And I used a bit of distress ink, the walnut stain, and the back is blank. So we're just going to quickly put it together. And all you need for this, I've just used bits of chipboard that I have lying around, not paying rent, from, you know, mini albums that I've made and covers I've made for journals. And or cardboard, or of course just use cereal cover, cereal box. And if it's not firm enough, just glue them together, you know. Glue the two together and then put your papers on top. So where's the one I was busy with? You know, I've done one side, it's not a big thing to see. And I just have a few bits and pieces here. My glue is lying on its side, because then I don't have to shake it down. So I have this paper. You don't have to be exact. I'm just going to move my camera a little bit. I have a new camera, by the way. My husband gave it to me for my birthday. It's Wi-Fi, to hopefully improve on my YouTubes. So let's just put the glue. I do it this way. I stick it on the cardboard or whatever it is that you're using. That's all I do. Where's my cloth? Here it is. Just stick it on. Let's move it a little bit to the edge. How about that? It's so simple, so quick. I'm going to use the whole thing on here, actually. And don't limit yourself. Your imagination is your limit. You can use fabric. I don't have one of fabric, but you can do fabric on the back of one of these and pretty it up. You see this one? I didn't show you the back of this one. I put a bit of lace, and then I used washi tape. Can you see that? And this is just bond or typing paper, coffee dyed. And of course, this is from the Havana collection. So your imagination is your limit as to what you can use. All, the only thing you have to bear in mind is that it must be flat for writing. So I just use the name doodle boards. I think it's cute. And we're not going to get too serious about them. I'm actually using my, I should let it dry properly, the glue, because then this won't happen. But you know, I'm not gonna sit here and wait, and even though it only takes minutes. So try and let your glue dry first. And okay, that one worked better. Yeah. And look at that, it's there, it's done, it's done. So I messed up here. So why not? I've got a shoe. I think I'm going to use this one again. I always like to put a bit of glue, because you know, sometimes a washi tape doesn't stick down so well. Just bring a bit more light in here. Huh? I'm still working on my lighting. And it doesn't even have to go all the way up. So let's just put this on the edge. So pretty. Of course, you can just distress your edges too, like I've done, to make the look better. There we go. And that's a very simple one. Quick and easy little doodle boards to use in your journals to write on. And just make sure you know which edge you're going to add your little bit of lace or whatever it is you want to add on there, or charm, or tassels, or bits of ribbon. As you can see, this one I just put an eyelet on it, so you can do an eyelet and add all sorts of fluffies on the end. And I'm gluing on, there we go. And so yeah, I think I'm going to, and you can even use it to write on. That's why I did this one with paper, because I can use it to write on. Of course, when you make a journal, you can make your doodle board to match your journal. So keep that in mind when you're making a journal. Have some extra paper over, or whatever you're using for your doodle board. I think it's really, really cool. And let's say I'm going to put, I'm going to cover that. I don't want to cover that. Yeah, I think I'm going to put that here. Let's cut this off. You know me, I love my fabrics and my lace and my pulls and all my little blingy bits. And it is a bit long, you know that? So I think I'm just going to, I'm going to cut this off and only use the lace. There we go. And I mean, you can put it anywhere you want. I'm just putting it, and let's make sure I'm putting it on the side I want it to be. This, by the way, is lace from an old blouse of mine. It no longer fits me. Since all my surgeries, I've put on quite a bit of weight. I can no longer go running or cycling or do anything. Yeah, anyway, so just a quick example, I can still put ribbon on here. I can even add, look at this, I've got this little thing lying around here. That's so pretty, I like that. And then maybe a flower on there, a flower, a bow. Ugh, like I say, the possibilities, I think I would like to put, I don't have any flowers handy here. Uh-oh, look at this. Stick it down again. There we go. Beautiful. And okay, I've got this teeny weeny flower here, which is actually perfect. How about that? This will do, just to cover that spot there. And look, there you have another doodle board for your journals. Because I write in my journals. I don't think I've done a video on this one, I must, because it's just gorgeous and I'm keeping it for myself. Because my other one, I have a few journals that I write in. Look at that. Now you've got the pretty on the side if you want it. And look how gorgeous it looks, so it hangs out of the journal. So my ladybugs, I just thought I would show you this little quick and easy tutorial on the doodle boards. And it really does make writing so much easier. So I will see you guys again very soon. Stay safe, and if you're in the winter months like us, stay warm and stay healthy. Love you guys lots. Ciao now. Bye bye.